As part of this cover-up, India has further intensified its violations of the ceasefire along the line of control and the working boundary. Since the 1st of January 2020, India has committed 1,440 ceasefire violations in breach of the 2003 ceasefire understanding. India has deliberately targeted innocent civilians on the Pakistani side of the LOC, killing 13 and injuring 104, including women and children. There is a possibility that in order to divert world's attention from its state terrorism and unacceptable actions in Indian-occupied Jammu and Kashmir, India may resort to false flag operation and undertake some other misadventure which could imperil regional peace and security. Despite Indian military and political leaders' belligerent rhetoric and aggressive actions on the ground, Pakistan has exercised maximum restraint. Pakistan does not want another conflict. However, it has the will and the capacity to respond forcefully and effectively and defend itself resolutely against any act of aggression. Excellencies, as their valiant struggle in the past amply testifies, the Kashmiri people will never accept the sinister Hindutva agenda of dispossessing them of their land, marginalizing them politically and economically, and depriving them of their distinct identity. I have personally briefed the UN Secretary General, President of the Security Council, OIC Secretary General, and my counterparts from around the world on the plight of Kashmiris and the worsening conditions in the occupied territory. The UN Secretary General, the High Commissioner for Human Rights, parliaments, human rights and civil society organizations have voiced their serious concern. The UN Secretary General, the international media too has broken its long silence since the situation is so grave and the violation of the Kashmiri rights so egregious. Dear colleagues, the Jammu and Kashmir dispute, just like Palestine, continues to be the longest standing item on the UN and OIC agenda. The occupying powers in both Kashmir and Palestine are pursuing similar tactics to disenfranchise and dispossess these peoples. Both these situations are worsening and call for urgent attention of the international community. Pakistan greatly appreciates the OIC's continued and unequivocal support on the Jammu and Kashmir dispute. This organization has been at the forefront of efforts to support the just and legitimate struggle of the people of Indian occupied Jammu and Kashmir for their inalienable right to self-determination, as reflected by the decisions and resolutions of the Islamic summits and Council of Foreign Ministers sessions, and the statements issued by the General Secretariat and the IPHRC. The OIC's contact group has done valuable work in galvanizing world attention to the worsening situation in Indian-occupied Jammu and Kashmir. The recent visit of the Secretary General's Special Envoy for Jammu and Kashmir to Pakistan and Azad Kashmir was another manifestation of the OIC's solidarity with the Kashmiri people. In view of the grave situation, it is imperative that the OIC steps up its efforts to facilitate a lasting solution to the Jammu and Kashmir dispute. the oppressed people of the Indian occupied Jammu and Kashmir now more than ever count on OIC and the Muslim Ummah. The OIC must urge India to rescind its unilateral and illegal actions since 5th of August 2019, implement the relevant UN Security Council resolutions to hold a UN supervised plebiscite in Indian occupied Jammu and Kashmir, halt its blatant human rights violations, and provide unhindered access to OIC, IPHRC, UN, human rights organizations, and international media to investigate and report on the situation in the occupied territory. I also request Your Excellency's active support in raising the issue at the various international fora, including the UN and Human Rights Council, through the OIC platform. To express our solidarity with the beleaguered people of Indian occupied Jammu and Kashmir, a communique has been prepared. I hope it would be unanimously endorsed. Before concluding my remarks, I once again thank you on behalf of the government and the people of Pakistan for your participation and invaluable contributions. I thank you.
وزیر خارجہ شاہ محمود قریشی او آئی سی کے کشمیر رابطہ گروپ کا ہنگامی اجلاس جو طلب کیا گیا تھا اس سے خطاب کر رہے تھے۔